Hey, ladies and gentlemen. It's that time. It's that time. Yes. The it's photo time. I want a copy of this one. Please text me that. Okay. So I'm very, 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 very happy and proud to announce that Michael Cleveland and Flamekeeper are going to be playing for us right now. So they're going to tune up their instruments, and then they're going to rip our socks off and make our hair fall out of the top of our heads all at the same time. So it's such a great thing to have everybody be able to fit in here, and I'm so psyched. And so thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you to everybody. Thanks to my volunteers. Thank you, thank you. Michael Cleveland and Flamekeeper, y'all.
Well, I don't know how we're going to follow that, but we better get to work. That's all I can say. John Glick and Warren Blair and Mike Mumford and Mark McGlashan, they're a hard act to follow. Josh Daniels. Ready, John?
Whatever you are, man.
Son, you got to kick it off. All right. Wear it out.
Thank you.
Well, it's so great to be here. Thank you all for coming and spending your Sunday with us. And thanks to everybody here at the TileWorks and Peter and everybody for having us out. We really appreciate it. I figured that I would just talk the rest of the set. From here, guys, you're free to go. I was born. We're going to play music because that's all we really know how to do. We had a record come out back in March called The Lovin' of the Game, and we'd like to do you some songs from that album right now. And this first song we're going to do is one that I heard during the COVID pandemic when touring had stopped and we weren't really able to play a lot of music together. And I do a lot of recording at home for people. People send me tracks to play fiddle and mandolin and all kinds of instruments on. Kazoo, I play that on some of them. So this guy sent me his version to play some instruments on, and I heard this song and I liked it immediately and knew I wanted to record it. Kind of talks about that time and that we're out of it now and that we're able to be in the same room and hang out together and play music the way it should be. It's called Sunny Days Are Coming Once Again. Thank you. Don't make me come out there.
She's gone and I'm all alone.
Well, that's a song called Nasty Gone from my new album. Hey, I want you to meet the rest of these guys in my band. Back here on the bass, that's Chris Douglas, everybody. We're working real hard for you out there on the sound. I'm just everywhere today, but just out there on the sound, we couldn't do it without him. His name is Elliot Beckley. How about a nice hand for Elliot? And this mandolin player, he's gonna play you too. Oh yeah, the guy that just got done singing that song for you. I can't forget him. His name is Josh Richards. Yeah. And we're gonna get this mandolin player to play you too. This is Nathan Livers. How about a hand for Nathan? Has a very important announcement before the song.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Has anybody out there got the blues today? Oh, yeah. Yeah? All right. The song is just for you, then. A friend of mine back in Kentucky wrote this, dude, a guy he used to play music with, and we were looking for some material and found this song, and we recorded it, and then we put it out on a single out there on the what we call streaming services, so you can check it out. And I guess the guy really had the blues when he wrote this song, but it's one called The Blues Are Close at Hand. Thank you. Yeah, it ain't nothing. We all stick around, cause they all tell us to.
Thank you.
Oh, thank you all so much for such a great audience. That was a song called The Tall Fiddler that we recorded with that crazy guitar player, Tommy Emmanuel, a couple years ago. And that was written about a great fiddle player who we lost a few years back named Byron Berline. And he was a big, tall dude. It sure wasn't written about me, I can tell you that. It would have been the 5'4 fiddler if it was written.
Short fiddler?
The short fiddler.
Like short ribs?
Right. Maybe. You got any?
Maybe after the show.
All right.
By the way, thanks for all the fine cooking today.
Yeah.
Wow. Well, they really hooked us up.
So this next song we're going to do is another song off that Tall Fiddler album. This is one that was written by a guy named John Hyatt. We bluegrassed it up a little bit. It's about a guy who picks up a hitchhiker and they end up robbing banks all the way from Reno, Nevada to Memphis, Tennessee. And once they get to Memphis, Tennessee, they break into Graceland. And they steal one of Elvis Presley's Cadillacs. One of Elvis's Cadillacs. My ears are going nuts.
Uh-oh.
That's a new cable. This is one called the Tennessee Plates.
Yeah. Woo! Two! One, two, three, hold it! See you.
Well, thank you all so much. You know, I can tell you all are bluegrass fans. You all have heard a lot of bluegrass over the years. And, I mean, you know how it goes. The melody to these songs are usually pretty happy sounding. And, you know, you listen to the tempos of the songs, and they're all pretty fast and all that. But when you listen to the lyrics of the songs, it gets depressing really fast. You know, like drowning your lover in the river because you loved her too much. As a matter of fact, I was going to let you guys know there's going to be another show later tonight, because we've been having van problems this weekend. So we're going to, where's the nearest river? Would you all come watch us drown our van in the river? What do you think, Josh?
Yeah, I think so.
Is there a river?
I'm sure we could find one somewhere. Right outside, yeah.
Right outside, there you go. Yeah.
Oh, shoot.
Hey, I just saw it go by.
Watching the river roll by.
There you go.
Watching the river.
Well, this next tune we're going to do is an original number of mine, and it gets a little bit out there, kind of like some of these bluegrass tunes and bad topics. We used to sing about making moonshine and running that, but that's legal now, so whoop-de-doo. And I wanted to write a song, and the only thing that popped in my head was peyote. I don't know why, but it did. But I didn't know anything about it, so I got on Wikipedia and was reading about it, and there's a substance in it called mescaline that causes you to hallucinate and trip. And the Native Americans, they still use it. And, this song isn't really about drugs or anything. This is more about a guy's bad luck out in the desert. So, we all go on a little trip with us. It's an eerie feeling, hero call. Now peyote is my best friend, and I'm tripping on some mescaline. Thank you. howdy how in the nighttime falls. It's an eerie feeling here across. Now Phil is my best friend, and I'm tripping on some escalade.
Telling you about called The Loving of the Game. Kick it off, Nathan Liver. Thank you. That's a little slow one. We need to play one of those every once in a while. Keep the rain away. All right. How many people out there are in love? All right.
Good number. I didn't see any hands, Mike.
I didn't see any hands either.
All right, let's try it again. How many people are out there in love? I saw some hands this time.
Yeah.
I also saw, I saw this lady in the front row elbow her husband and be like, you put your hand up, mister.
Get your hand up right now. Chris, is your bass in love today?
Let me ask you. Yes, it is.
Okay.
This
show
just got weird.
It really got weird. I don't even know what just happened there. I know it got weird.
My wife's a puppeteer.
Just got weird.
Chris?
Yes, sir.
Slap that bass in a loving way.
Oh, it just got real weird.
Oh,
Is Mike Muckford hiding out in here somewhere?
I think I saw him just go ahead for his banjo.
He's going for the banjo now.
Where's that layout boy been? Old Mike Muckford. We're gonna get Mike up and maybe play a couple fiddle and banjo tunes just to amuse ourselves, if nothing else. We don't get to play together usually but about once a year, and that's at IBMA, and we get in a big jam. We start about 11 o'clock. I tell you what, last year, he was like, man, I don't think I'll be able to play super late. We got to leave early. And I was like, that's cool, man. Let's just play a few or whatever. Well, about 8 a.m., the jam broke up, and they got in the van and left. I've learned more fiddle tunes from Mike Muffert, I think, than most fiddle players I've ever got to jam. Mike's been trying to get me to learn for years, and I finally learned it last time because I knew we were going to jam.
Okay. Could I just say one thing about Mike Cleveland?
Uh-oh.
There's a lot to say about this guy, but this is the only guy, well, there are a lot of amazing musicians out there, but this guy knows a tune before he's ever heard it. I mean, it's really true. It's like this guy's got so much music and so much instinct in him. It's unbelievable. We are absolutely blessed to have him around.
No pressure.
Yeah, Mike, your check will be out in the van there for you, brother.
Nathan, why don't you say stuff like that about me every once in a while? I'm gonna get the tune eventually.
Thank you.
Go home, but if Warren or Josh or Mark or any of y'all want to come up and mash on a little Sally Gooden with us, you're welcome to do it. Because we're going to play it.
Are they coming? I don't know. I see a door opening and closing like you're back there grabbing instruments.
Warren and Josh are still back there.
As one door closes, another one opens. As they always say. And there's a banjo case on the other side of each door.
Yeah. Alright.
Just a reminder, the drowning of the van in the river will take place at 9 p.m. tonight. $20 a head.
Unique place I think I've ever played.
Yeah.
Biggest fireplace I've ever seen, I believe.
Pretty cool. I like it.
Hey, we ran them off.
Ran them off.
Ran them off.
Scared them off, man. That's all right.
We can do it now.
My ride left.
Get it. besides Joe, Neil, and Bentley, we're like a Cleveland Flamekeeper. Thank you all.
Take this moment and tell you about our CD table is set up over there. We've got the new album that's out, and we have the album Tall Fiddler that won a Grammy a few years ago, and then we have a whole bunch of other Grammy losing albums as well. Check out. They're not bad, they're just losing.
Josh, that'll be $20 for the show at 9 p.m. I'll take you $20.
I'll go down with the ship, huh?
Go down with the what?
I'll go down with the ship.
Okay, I thought that's what you said.
We also have some t-shirts over there. You can see Michael's driving a Cadillac on the t-shirt.
That's the closest I'll ever come to that driving Cadillac.
That Cadillac is also in the river. I don't know.
No, it ain't. I know who's got it.
But thank you all so much for coming out and venturing out in this, what is it, Ophelia? Is that a name? Storm.
Come up here, and he was clamped to the fourth fret, son. He's serious.
This was our favorite song during the pandemic, and it really tells the tale of our lives during that time. We'll call it Lost All My Money for $2. In.
Thank you, everybody. There they go. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, man. Thanks so much for coming. Hey, there's a barbecue truck out there still loaded with flesh. So take some flesh home. Take some flesh home. Thanks, everybody. Thank you so much. Pick up some Michael CDs over there and a t-shirt. And there's TileWorks tie-dyes over there. And thank you, everybody.